In this guide, we are going to learn about various joints provided in concrete flooring. Joints are planned breaks in concrete, which allows the RCC to move and prevent random cracking. There are four types of joints: expansion, isolation, contraction, and construction joints. Construction joints. These are provided at the location where concrete work is stopped temporarily. Tie bars are provided for good bonding between abutting sections of concrete. Rails is used to support the edge of the concrete joint, is normally running through the joint. Expansion joints. They permit thermal contraction and expansion, without inducing stresses into the elements. The building longer than a 45 meter are generally provided with one or more expansion joints. Recommended center to center spacing is 30 meters. The joints are formed by providing a material such as thermoclin filled with joint fillers. Isolation joints. These joints totally separate a concrete element from another concrete element, or a fixed object such as a wall or column, so that each can move and not affect the other. The joint filling should be full depth. It can be made of cork, foam rubber, or some other flexible material. Contraction joints. Also called control joints. Joints are introduced in concrete structure to localize shrinkage movement. As the structure will shrink, the joints open slightly, and cracks will develop in the joints, rather than in a random manner. These are grouped, formed, or sawed into sidewalks, driveways, pavements, floors. Joint fillers. Joint fillers are hard, semi-rigid materials typically used to fill joints in concrete floors. The joint filler must be able to transfer the load of heavy wheel traffic across the joint, and protecting the joint edges from damage. Commonly used joint fillers are bitumen, epoxy or polyurethane based. Their main purpose is also to prevent water, other liquids, and debris from entering the joint. They also need to improve the appearance of the floor. Timing of joint filling and sealing. Joint filling be postponed as long as possible to minimize joint filler splitting and cracking. This condition occurs because the concrete slab shrinks and the joint itself widens. Semi-rigid epoxy and polyurethane fillers are not flexible enough to withstand joint widening, and may split when concrete shrinkage has occurred.